Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today is part 9 of our VBA series, where we are going to find the location of a particular string inside of another string to continue our lesson last week on string functions. We are going to go over 3 functions this week: the length function, the INSTR function, and the INSTRREV function. And all of these functions are very useful for creating variables inside a VBA that will be used to strip out certain parts of a string. So our spreadsheet today is a list of possible file names. And if you look closely at these file names, you will see that there's some repeating characters in here. For example, you will see that there is a forward slash in a lot of these file names that's used over and over again, because file names multiple levels down in your file system use a slash. So how do we know which slash to use to get to the part of that string that we really want to use? So that's what we're hoping to cover today with our VBA code. So let's quickly review a few of the functions that we used last week, because we are going to be using the same spreadsheet to talk about where the location in our string is that we wish to find. So first of all, we had the left function, and then we had the right function. But what I would really like to review right now is the mid function. When you look in the mid function right here, you can see that it takes 3 arguments. It takes the string that you wish to search, and this 17 here, this is a starting point. But I have hard-coded the number 17 in here. And what I would really like to do is choose this location where I would like to start based on where I find another substring. And that's where our INSTR function will come in today. And this 10 right here is still the length of how much I want to take out of the string. But I can also use this right here to also dynamically come up with a number based on the location in a string. So let's see how that is done. Sometimes you want to start a string at a certain place in your code. You saw how I manually calculated this 17, but what if I wanted this 17 right here to be a variable? I'm going to go up here and declare dim int. Remember, it was a long variable that it was looking for, which is the same thing as an integer. Int start as integer. So I'm going to copy my int start, and I'm going to go down here, and I'm going to set int start equal to a number. And what number do I want? Just for this case, I would like to find this first slash right here. So I'm going to set my INSTRREV equal to INSTR, which means in string, with a left parenthesis. And where do I want to start? At 0. And what is my first string that I wish to evaluate? The first string I wish to evaluate is my STR mid. And the character I would like to look for in double quotes is this forward slash. And then I'm going to end my string and hit enter. However, if you notice, str mid hasn't been set as a value yet, so I'm just going to cut this with control X and paste it right under here. And then instead of this 17, I'm going to put my variable here, because I could have different paths starting at a different number depending on where I find this slash. So I'm going to set my breakpoint here so we can see what happens. Alt tab back to Excel, run my macro. And I'm going to hit F8. And again, what is my str mid? And it is my full path. And then I'm going to hit F8 again. And this time I'm going to go to int start. And if I'm looking at my entire path, I'm looking for the first forward slash. And that should be at character number 3. So when I hit enter, I am in fact returned with a 3. So now what is this mid function down here going to do? It is going to get the 10 characters starting at place 3 inside of my str mid. So if I hit function F8 and I go up here and I go to str mid and I hit enter, you will see my top FO. And also there's no space on the end of that because I use my trim function. You can see that this is 10 characters long. And that is exactly what I wanted my function to do. So I'm going to hit F8 to stop executing my code. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. We used INSTR to find the first slash, but what if I wanted to find the last slash? I'm going to just change my function right here a little bit. And instead of saying INSTR, I'm going to type INSTRREV. And what that's going to do is tell me where my last slash starts. So I'm going to Alt tab back to Excel, run my macro, and I'm going to hit F8, and I'm going to see what my str mid starts with. Again, it's my file path. And now I'm going to hit F8 again, and I want to see what my int start is in this case. And I'm going to hit enter, and I will see now that it is 51. And that is true, because this is the 51st character over here. I did count this previously, but if you would like to take a look at the spreadsheet that we've provided as an example, you can see that this is over 51 characters. So now I'm going to start this MID function at the 51st character, and I'm going to go over 10 characters. So if I hit F8 and I go down here after the question mark and I do STR MID and hit enter, you will see that I got the slash name in there and I didn't get the S on the end like I had hoped. So sometimes I want to find where the string is and I want to start one after that. So I'm going to hit F8 to finish the code. And I'm going to go back here into my code and see where it says INSTR. I'm just going to put a +1 because INSTR is an integer, so I can add 1 to it. So if I alt tab back to Excel and I hit macros and I hit run, I'm going to hit F8 all the way through to my last line of code. And I'm going to go back to STR MID and you will see that I returned the name of my file. And I'm going to hit function F8 to finish. One more function that we need to know. And I'm going to go up here and go dim int length as integer. It's often very important to know the length of a whole string that you are dealing with. So I'm going to set int length down here equal to LEN, which is the length function of STR MID. And I will be returned with how long my actual string is, because sometimes I want to do subtraction. See right here how I'm picking 10 characters? Sometimes I want to pick the final characters. So int length will give me how long this entire string is, and int start will give me where I'm going to start counting. So if I do right here, int length minus int start, I will be getting the very end of my string. Let's go back to Excel and run our macro and hit F8 until we get to int length. I'm going to delete this code that's out here, and I'm just going to type in question mark int start, which is still 51, and then int length, which is 61. So I can see the difference between those two is about 10. And in this case, we've been using 10, but that happens to be how long my file name is. If I hit F8 and I look up here at the value of what my string returning actually is, you will see that I am actually getting the entire length of what that string will be. So I'm going to hit function F8 and I'm going to go back to Excel. And right here, I'm going to change my file to my file 123 so that this is longer than 10 characters. And then I'm going to go back to macros and I'm going to run this macro again. And if I F8 all the way to the bottom and I get the value of the STR MID, you will see that it's not just pulling 10 characters. It's pulling however long the string is minus where my starting point was. And I know that because if I go back here to int length and hit enter, it is no longer 61 long, it is 64. This length that I'm trying to get, this argument inside of my MID function, is now the 64 minus the 51. That's how many characters I want to return. And that just happens to be 13, which if I alt tab back to Excel, you will see that this file name is no longer 10 characters long, but 13. So I'm going to alt tab, hit F8 to finish running my code and release my breakpoint right here. So in review today, we used a couple different starting variables, which was INSTR and INSTRREV, which allows for both the first instance of a character in a string and the last instance of a character in a string. And the length function to calculate the length of a string. And we put all of these together to use the very valuable MID function to parse a string. Next time, we're going to talk about mistakes to avoid when writing code in VBA. Hopefully you learned something new today and look forward to seeing you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.